Welcome back to a brand new series, Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. Continuing on with our cranial nerve series, it's now time to take a look at the fourth cranial nerve, the trochlear nerve. In this video, we'll first describe the course of this nerve, explore briefly the function of the muscle it innervates, and then round off by looking at a few clinical conditions associated with this nerve. The trochlear nerve is derived from the Latin word trochlear, which means pulley. During this video, we'll examine some of the special features of this nerve. From a posterior view, you can see that this nerve begins at the back of the brain stem. The nuclei of the trochlear nerve are illustrated, one on the left and the other on the right. The nucleus of the trochlear nerve is found at the level of the inferior colliculus of the midbrain. Fibers from each nucleus decussate, which means crossover, before the trochlear nerve emerges from the brainstem below the inferior colliculus. This means that the right trochlear nerve originates from the left trochlear nucleus, and vice versa. We will discuss the importance of this relationship in the clinical correlates. The trochlear nerve emerges below the inferior colliculus, and looking at this from a lateral view, we can see that the trochlear nerve circles laterally around the brainstem and runs anteriorly towards the eye. It passes between the posterior cerebral artery and the superior cerebellar artery on the lateral aspect of the pons, and then pierces the dura just under the free margin of the tensorium cerebelli. It runs on the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus below the oculomotor nerve. Finally, it enters the orbit through the superior orbital fissure and then reaches the superior oblique muscle, where it provides somatic motor innervation. As we said previously, the trochlear nerve innervates a single extraocular muscle, the superior oblique muscle. The superior oblique muscle is a spindle-shaped muscle that originates in the sphenoid bone, in the upper medial side of the orbit. From its origin, the superior oblique muscle proceeds anteriorly, where it becomes tendinous and loops through the trochlea, a fibrocartilaginous pulley attached to the trochlear fovea of the frontal bone. The trochlear nerve is named after this structure. The tendon then travels posterior laterally to attach to the sclera at the posterior temporal surface of the eyeball. The unique path of the superior oblique muscle looping through the trochlea enables abduction, moving the eyeball laterally, depression, moving the eyeball downwards, and internal rotation, rotating the eyeball medially. Now let's have a look at how dysfunction of this nerve may occur and present clinically. Damage to the trochlear nerve can either be congenital or acquired. Congenital defects result in the malformation of the nucleus or the nerve. Acquired defects, like a brainstem stroke, can also affect the nucleus. The nerve itself can be damaged due to trauma and other conditions. Remember, fibers emerging from the nucleus decussate before emerging from the brainstem, resulting in contralateral symptoms when the nucleus is affected. Damage to the nerve results in ipsilateral symptoms. Trochlear nerve palsy leads to paralysis of the superior oblique muscle. This presents as vertical diplopia or double vision, commonly observed when a patient looks downwards when walking down the stairs. Hopefully now you're able to describe the course of the trochlear nerve, understand the function of the superior oblique muscle, and also describe the likely causes and symptoms of damage to this nerve. There you have it. We hope you enjoyed this video on the trochlear nerve. Stay tuned for the rest of our series and be sure to hit the like button and subscribe for more top-class anatomy content.